So, this interesting point has a special name. It has two names. The point is called, we denote it by F usually, and it is called the Have you heard these names?
Firma.
Firma is what?
Firma
is famous for what?
For his theorem.
For his theorem. Even not what, but if. There are. Do you know small Firma theorem? Malutai or Firma? Maybe you have already taught. No? Mm-hmm. Have you heard about
it? Yes, I have. Yes. Mm-hmm.
It's about what?
It's about if.
About what objects? Is in geometry or in algebra or in.
In algebra.
Well, actually, in arithmetic.
Yes.
What it means?
Yes.
A power p is congruent to A mod p. Remember this? Or you know this? So,
yes.
What was this in this notation? Maybe it's a little bit different, but if p is a prime number and a is any number, then we'll have this.
Sorry, right now
there is
more than p and so
on. There are different ways of English. You can write it this way and the answer. Okay, so there's a small Firma theorem. Big Firma theorem, I won't write it here because. I think you must have heard about it anyway. But also he is famous for his works in calculus. What does it mean? So he can report to me from my history. There was no calculus at that time, unless you mean from my history. But he is one of those who created calculus. Calculus was created by two other famous people, Leibniz and Newton. Analysis of Leibniz and Newton.
Leibniz.
Now we have our Leibniz cookies, and but this was later, and they invented the notions of derivative and so on. But Firma also found methods that are actually methods of mathematical analysis on нашел методы, которые фактически являются методами математического анализа для решения задач на максимум и минимум. So he was solving problems, extremal problems, экстремальные задачи. Extremal means means maximum or minimum. The extreme value, the greatest or the smallest. So he was trying to solve various extremal problems, and he created methods to do it, which are actually the basis of modern calculus. Он еще придумал такие методы, которые он применял, фактически были методами математического анализа. And this point F is also famous for its extremal property. This proof, the proof by Chev theorem, doesn't tell us what is this point about, why it is interesting. Well, the only thing it says that, okay, these three lines meet at this point, concur, and this is interesting in itself. Okay, то, что эти три линии пересекаются в ответ, это тоже, конечно, интересно. But this is not as interesting as the property of this point that I will now explain. Before we pass to the extremal property of the point F, Firma's point, I want to remind you some properties that we already know about this theorem. And they are the three segments, AA1, BB1, and CC1 are equal, and the angles between them are what? Equal and equal to 60 degrees. Some understanding, and this is a very beautiful book. So I want to show it. So let's do the following thing. You will be based on your intuition. Будем опираться на вашу интуицию физическую, если вы себе представите, вы поймете. Хотя строго обосновать физически вы, наверное, пока еще не можете, вы еще физику не учили, да? Не учили еще? Коля, а ты учил уже? Okay, anyway, it doesn't matter. Almost doesn't matter. So let's take our triangle. I draw it on the board. And then let's take three nails. You know what is a nail? Ah, no. In this case, it is wood. Three nails and drive them at this three points. So you should imagine they're sticking out. Okay? Then I take three ropes and tie them together. Три веревочки и из одного узла в одном узле их свяжу. And I pass these ropes through the nails so that they hang down. Here I have it. Then I take three weights, three boga, and tie them here to the rope. They must be equal weights. One, and one. And let go. Зеркало, поскольку точка вот этого узелок остановится в конце концов. это значит, что сумма сил, которые на него действуют, равна нулю. Понятно? Когда мы... Вот я тяну за руку. When I pull this weight, so I pull the rope and I pull that point. This weight also pulls this point. And there is a force acting on this point. 1 kilo. And each rope acts with the same force, 1 kilo, whatever, 1 gram. 1 kilo. Okay? And if the sum of the forces were not zero, then the point would move. The summa sigma varia sigma. So we have 3 vectors. Do you know how to add vectors? Знаете, вот как складывать векторы? Саша, нет? Юля, do you know? Okay. Well, never mind. It's you, as I said, you will understand it, really understand it later. But so if you imagine that, so imagine that me and Poli will take a rope and we tie it to some, I don't know, big table here, and we'll pull, I pull and he pulls. So in what direction will the table move? Yes. Yes, yes. So if one force acts this way, the other force acts this way, and they are of different value, of different magnitude, so I will pull stronger than Коля, I think, or maybe Коля will pull stronger than me. Кто-то из нас тянет сильнее, тот слабее, соответственно, вектор будет того, кто сильнее тянет, того вектор, того, ту силу вектор отображает более длинный вектор. But the resulting force, одна сила, которая две силы, может принять одной. And this is done by the parallelogram. So like this. Okay? So you just believe that this is so. We can obtain the same resulting force if we add this vector and then this, I can write and draw it here. This will be a triangle. Is правило параллелограмма, is правило треугольника. Ну, ладно, дают один тот же результат. Понятно? Окей. So, now I have 3 forces. Equal forces. And they give 0 sum. So, I apply 1 force. I draw 1 force. One of the 3 vectors, then the second one of the same length, and then the third one, and the third one must come to the beginning because the sum is zero, and these 3 sides are equal. So, what are the angles between the forces?
60 degrees.
Well, in fact, not 60, but 120, because with the this is the angle. So each of these angles is 180 degrees and 20 degrees. And we have proved that the Fermat statement by using Philip. You can say that this is not a rigorous proof, and in a way it is not, especially that you don't know forces. Можно сказать, что это не строгая доказательство, тем более, что вы не знаете, что такое сильный друг. Therefore, we must prove it. Give a moment method. Но на самом деле это доказательство вполне хорошее. Потому что та часть физики, на которой